So Horeb is excited today because we are celebrating World Sunday School Day. Especially our kids are excited. Our Kunyandi is going to be the special speaker for us. Yes, please do come forward. I don't think that I have to say anything beyond. Please come forward, and she's going to deliver the word of God for us today.
Respected Achin, my dear sisters and brothers in Christ, and my loving Sunday school children. Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. First, I thank God Almighty for strengthening me to stand here today and share from the Word of God. Thank you, Kochumin Achin, Sunday School Principal, Dr. Minnie Thomas, and committee members for giving me this opportunity. It is an honor for me to speak on this special Sunday for our children. Every year around the globe, World Sunday School Day is celebrated on the first Sunday of November. I appreciate all our Horeb children here for their enthusiasm in studying Word of God. The theme for today's message is Jesus Christ who embraces our children, which is based on the Gospel, St. Mark, chapter 10, verses 13 to 16. St. Mark, chapter 10, verses 13 to 16. Let's pray. Gracious Father, we love you. We, your children, come before you with a heart of thanksgiving and praise. Beloved Father, we thank you for the gift of your word. May we be filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. Help us to understand your word and help us to grow in faith. We submit our Sunday school children and our ministry to thy hands. Let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my hearts and the minds in appreciate in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Before we share the word of God, I want to give you a short history of Sunday school and the World Sunday School Day. Why do we celebrate World Sunday School Day? The day honors the founding of the first Sunday school in 1780 by an English newspaper publisher, Robert Rex, in England. Many children in England were forced to work 6 days per week, 6 days a week in factories without any break. And Sunday was the only day off they have. On Sundays, then they used to play in the street without any supervision. Mr. Rex had a heart and concern for these children. In order to solve this problem, he decided to start a school which met on Sunday, because Sunday was the only day off for the children. He found some teachers and paid for them, and the children used to meet on their homes for this class. And they didn't have any textbook that time. Bible was the textbook or primary teaching tool. In that Sunday school, the teachers taught them reading, writing, and basic math and religious education. Soon, the Sunday school became very popular in United States and Europe. In both Europe and America, compulsory state education was established by the year 1870. After that, reading and writing were taught only during weekdays. And the Sunday school curriculum was limited to religious education. Over the years, Sunday school evolved into what we experience today. In Kerala, the reformers realized the importance of Bible study. And this year, for our Marthoma Sabha, we mark the 120th year of Marthoma Sunday School Samajam. Marthoma Sunday School Samajam was established in the year 1905 at Maraman Convention. This time, let us remember and thank God for all our faithful leaders we had and also who are leading us. The motto of Marthoma Sunday School is, come to Jesus and bring every child to Jesus. Along with family, Sunday school and church play an important part in growing, in molding our children in growing in faith and wisdom. The purpose of Sunday school is to deepen kids' understanding of our faith, build meaningful relationship with other children and the church. A Sunday school teacher's teaching and prayer should be based on a deep desire to see their students grow in faith and have a strong relationship with Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The responsibility of passing down the living word to our successive generation is vital in the mission of a church. Let us thank God for his manifold blessings for all of us today and bringing us in his faith, which we cherish, and that's why we all are here in this holy place now. I gratefully remember my parents and Sunday school teachers teaching me to seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all these things shall be added unto you. Let us pray that our children will also be able to say the same thing in the future. I always praise God and thank God for my family and also the family of Horeb. Ephesians chapter 6, verses 1 to 4. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother, which is the best first commandment with a promise, so that it may go well with you and so that you may enjoy long life on this earth. Fathers, do not exasperate your children. Instead, bring them in the faith and training and instruction of the Lord. In this passage, Saint Paul clearly tells the responsibility of the children and also the parents. This is like a two sides of a coin. Parents and teachers, let us pray always for our children. Teachers, please pray for each other also. Parents and family, as the primary and most impactful spiritual influence in child's life. Teaching by example and prioritizing Jesus is essential for our children's growth. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verses 14 to 17. We see that Timothy discovered his faith and identity in Christ at a very young age. How? Because his mother Eunice and grandmother Lois were faithful in instructing him and teaching Timothy the truth of scripture. That contributed to his ability to be an effective teacher and leader in the church. Later, Timothy was mentored by Saint Paul. The theme for this year's Sunday School Day, as I said before, is Jesus Christ who embraces children, who is based on Mark 10, verse 13 to 16. I would like to have one of the Sunday school children read this passage. Saint Mark, chapter 10, verses 13 to 16. Sunday school children, please. I hope you have the Bible with you today. Saint Mark, chapter 10, verses 13 to 16. Thank you. Matthew, Mark, and Luke each share the story of Jesus welcoming and blessing children. After the disciples tried to send them away, we have seen this beautiful pictures of children sitting on his knee and standing around him. Let us explore this theme and passage in detail. First point, parents bringing children to Jesus. Verse 13, chapter 10, verse 13. The act of bringing children to Jesus was very deeply spiritual and significant in the context of Jesus' ministry. This is not like parents taking their children for fun or to see any celebrity. Children were brought to Rabbi to be blessed and dedicated to God. And people viewed Jesus not only as a teacher, but they started realizing his power and authority. Second, verse 13b part, hindering children from Jesus. We see that not everyone was happy with bringing children to Jesus. The people who were the most unhappy were the disciples. The disciples rebuked the people. Perhaps they believed that Jesus was too busy with his teachings and miracles, and he didn't have any time for the children who were often seen as the lowest in the society, or they don't know power. Often, we are also like these disciples, hindering others from approaching Jesus. Third point, Jesus' invitation for the children. Verse 14, when Jesus saw this, he was indignant and said, "Let the children come to me and do not hinder them, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as this. Let the little children come," illustrating that children are the integral part of the kingdom of God. His interaction showed that they were not just passive observers, but they are the active members of his kingdom. Jesus said, "Whoever welcomes a child in his name also welcomes him." Jesus commanded only two things. First, look at that verse. Let the children come to me. Do not hinder them. Here the attitude of the disciples represents the forces around us and also our children, which pull us away from God. By the power of Holy Spirit and prayer, come closer to God and bring our children also. What do we get by coming to Jesus? Why it is important? St. John chapter 6, verse 35. Then Jesus declared, "I am the bread of the life. Whoever comes to me will never go hungry or thirsty." Let us accept his invitation and rededicate to his will. Fourth point, Jesus said, "Be like the children." He welcomes those who come like a children. Jesus emphasized the qualities like humility, love, illustrating that the kingdom is open to all who sincerely seek him. Just as a baby depends on the parents for all their needs, we too are helpless before God and depend on him. We must acknowledge our own weakness and rededicate our life to his will. Verse 10, 16. We see that Jesus blessed the children. When Jesus blessed the children, he affirmed their value and showed his love and care for them. When we are with Jesus, we are blessed. That's the only place we get the blessings. Children played a significant role in Jesus' ministry, serving as powerful examples of faith and innocence. Children were the first to announce Hosanna to the Son of David when Jesus entered Jerusalem. Children participated in miracles, feeding the 5,000 with the 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. Second example, synagogue's ruler Jairus' daughter died. Jesus raised from her. Another miracle with the boy with an unclean spirit, Jesus healed him. And there are so many miracles which children are involved, we can see in this scripture. These incidents reveal that children's great role in the ministry and in God's kingdom. We live each moment by His power, His grace, and His love. His presence transforms our circumstances. It is great to see that the Horeb Sunday School children and youth actively involved in our service, in our church ministry. I want to share two stories that illustrate depending on trusting in God. One is the legend of Poinsettia. I'm going to tell two stories. This legend comes from the people of Mexico and dates back to 17th century. It was a Christmas Eve in Mexico when people traveled to the nearest chapel for worship and laid their gifts before the baby Jesus in the nativity. A little girl named Pebida and her brother joined the families as they walked down the street. Pebida held her head very low, and she had sad face. The reason was she was very poor to buy a gift for baby Jesus. She was very sad. She didn't have any gift. But her cousin Pedro encouraged her, saying that even the smallest gift given in love would be appreciated by Jesus. The cousin said, even the smallest gift given in love, which will be appreciated by baby Jesus. Pebida saw some flowering weeds on the street and roadside, and she collected some of these weeds and made a beautiful, simple, very simple bouquet. And then she looked at the flowers. She was again discouraged. Oh, no one is going to like this simple bouquet. These are ugly wild flowers. And so I'm sure that this baby Jesus is not going to like my gift. And she was walking with a sad face. As they neared the nativity, Pebida bowed her head very low, but she drew courage from what her cousin said. Even the smallest gift given with love will be accepted. She stepped inside the church, little chapel, and approached the nativity scene. You know what happened? When she knelt down with her simple bouquet, it is said a miracle took place. The petals of these weeds changed into beautiful scarlet flowers. Pebida's face also bloomed with a smile, sensing the love of Savior she experienced. A poor little girl with nothing to give but herself and love. From this time onwards, the poinsettia become known as the flowers of the holy night. Jesus doesn't ask us more than we can give. In fact, all He wants is our love and trust. The second story, I'm going to tell one more story. The second story is often told as an incident in the life of Poland's famous pianist, Mr. Paderewski. Paderewski was a very famous Polish composer and pianist, and who was the third prime minister for Poland. One day, in the town, there was a concert by this famous pianist. A mother took her small boy to this concert. He was a very small boy, and he just started learning piano. She thought that, let me introduce to this famous pianist. They arrived early at the concert hall, and they were seated at the front's front. Standing alone on the stage was only a piano, grand piano. As they waited for the concert to begin, the mother entered into a conversation with the people sitting next to her. Eventually, 8 o'clock time came and the lights began to dim. Everyone turned their attention to the stage and the grand piano. The mother looked up and she couldn't find her son. She saw her son was sitting on the stage playing tingle tingle on this grand piano with her single finger. She got scared. As she began to make her way to the platform, Mr. Paderewski himself appeared on the stage. He was a very famous pianist. He went over and sat beside the child. He whispered in the child's ear, "Don't give up, keep playing." As the little boy continued to play, this great pianist reached down with his left hand and began to fill in the bass part. Then with the right arm around the little child, he added the running obbligato. Together, the old master and this little young boy held the crowd mesmerized. As God's children, many times we are tempted to feel like our gifts are very small. We don't have any gifts so that we can God can use us. But that's all he desires from us. Our willingness to use whatever talents we have given. Whenever we attempt something in his name, he comes along beside us. He lays down his arms around us and whispers to our ear, "Don't give up, keep playing." How many times we experience this in our life? Take a moment and think about that. How many times our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ came and sit next to us and put his hand around us and play the piano for us. When we offer something to God, and especially when we are offer it in pure and innocent heart, that's the, like this children in the story, the child in the story, God take us what we do and can create a masterpiece with it. His masterpieces are not necessarily outwardly beautiful or materially expensive. His masterpieces, however, the most lasting value and the greatest inner, with the greatest inner beauty. So the next time when you are tempted to think that your particular skill set is insignificant or that your life is otherwise without any meaning, remember this little story along with this verse from St. Paul. Philippians chapter 4, verses 13. I can do everything with him who gives me strength. I can do everything with him who gives me the strength. Let us come to Jesus like this, like innocent children, and trust him in every way of our life. Let us bring our children. Amen.
Our preacher, Susan Thomas, served the Sunday school as Sunday school superintendent as well as teacher. And thank you, Susan Andy, for the blessed, well-prepared, highly inspiring message. Let it be a source of blessing for every one of us. Now I request Janice to do the prayer for
us. Our gracious, loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for this Sunday that you've given us to come before you, O Lord. We come before you with our grateful hearts as we celebrate the World Sunday School Day. We thank you for the gift of teaching and learning in your name. We thank you for all our Sunday school, the teachers, and all the children, O Lord. We thank you for the privilege that you have given us as teachers to bring the Word of God to your little children, O Lord. Help us to be role models, to bring them closer to you, O Lord, through our actions, through the words that we speak. Please bless our Sunday school, the teachers, and the children who gather to grow in faith. May your love and wisdom shine through each lesson that we teach, inspiring our hearts to follow you. Help us to nurture a spirit of curiosity and understanding, fostering a community where all feel welcome, O Lord. Guide us in our mission to spread your word and love, empowering the next generation to walk in faith and share your message with the world. We pray for our Sunday school principal, the superintendent, the teachers, all the office bearers, Achin, and all the parents, O Lord, for giving us this ministry, O Lord. Bless us in all that we do, bringing glory to your name. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.